of the Pittsburgh Steelers, John Cole. The big Army lieutenant from Sweden, Lars Hedlund. Billy Kazmaier, the national powerlifting champion. Joe Doobie, the former World Olympic lifting champion. Cleve Dean, the arm and wrist wrestling champion of the world. Big Bill Anderson from the Highland Games in Scotland. Don Reinhout, the world record holder in powerlifting. Jerry Blackwell, a professional wrestler. And from the St. Louis Cardinals, Bob Young. Terry, how do you come up with a bunch of beef and potatoes like this from around the world?
These guys represent various sports in which strength is important. They were selected by a group of experts in the field of strength.
Each competitor is guaranteed $2,000 against bonus money. But when you see what the bonus money is, you'll know why they're so serious and why they try so hard.
Yeah, that'll buy a lot of that beef and potatoes.
$10,000 for first place, total bonus prize money of $25,000. And check out this point system, which will be used for 9 of the 10 events. 10 points for first place, $50 per point, and we're going to be here for the next 5 weeks. Now, last year's champion, Don Reinhout, in his winning lift, was 270 pounds. And the group we've got going today look like they're going to go beyond that. Beyond that means 290 pounds and three are left. Don Reinhout, who you just saw win this event last year, and Billy Kazmaier, who's chalking up. He's now moved to California. This big bull is going to give it a shot before Lars Hedlund, the Swede, comes on. Here's Kaz.
Kaz is so strong, it's just unbelievable. He has no technique. He has trouble getting his arms down, but he's so strong that he may just be able to press the weight overhead and hold it. Yes, sir. Look at that. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
It'd be hard to refuse that person anything. Would you buy a used car from Billy Kazmaier? The big guy from upstate New York. Good concentration.
Yeah, he's bearing down, using all the years of experience that he had as many times world powerlifting champion. He practiced this lift all year long. He has a big barrel at his home that he practices with. He has a real patterned, good way to do it. See, he steps forward with one foot.
He takes his time, too, doesn't he?
Yep, takes his time. Look at that. My goodness.
290.
I believe he can do over 300 if he has to.
Remember, last year's record was 270 by this same man. Here's Lars Hedlund.
Lars and Bill are not going to let this be won cheaply. He was an Olympic lifter at one time and lifted 500 pounds over his head, so you get an idea of how tough this event really, really is.
And he's vocal.
Oh, no.
Not quite?
Nope, not. He didn't hold it overhead and control it quite long enough to satisfy the judges. So they have to try it again. He's got 90 seconds to do it in, so he still has quite a bit of time left.
They stare at that barrel like there might be a rattlesnake in a gunny sack, don't they? They look at it like it's an animated object. Good position?
Yes, sir, he did it. Yes, sir, load on 300. Let's see it.
Kazmaier, Reinhout, and Lars Hedlund at 300 pounds. Look at this, breathing fire again. And all three finalists are over 300 pounds themselves, Terry, huh?
Yep, got to take a big man to lift these truly big weights because you've got to balance, use your own body to balance against the great weight that's inside the barrel in lead, shot, and water.
Kaz is struggling a little bit with his 300 pounds. I can understand it.
Yeah, he almost pressed it again. That's just unbelievable. But I think he's holding it too long now. His arms and shoulders are starting to start to deaden now.
300 pounds.
Well, he's got about 50 seconds left, but he spent a lot of energy. I don't know if he'll have enough left to give it another shot. We'll have to see.
Tell you, if all the events like this, the nine coming up or anything like this, I'm really impressed.
45 seconds.
Get on the records.
Yes.
No, he's going to let it go.
Reinhout now is going to strap on that big belt. Now, what looks like it should have a 45 on the end of it. What are those belts for?
But Tom, the competitors, you've noticed other ones with those belts on, they wear them so that they get a little extra support in the back and in the waist when they handle these terrific weights.
That one's pretty thick and a long way around. He's a big man. Reinhout's never really lifted 300 pounds, but he must be picked up seeing Kaz fail, huh?
Yeah, this gives him a chance to go into the lead now. He's never done this much even in practice, but I think he's trained for it.
Push it! Push it!
Oh, he's losing his balance. No, sir, he didn't hold it up. He got it overhead, but he didn't balance it, but so close.
No cigar, right?
No, no cigar. He's got a little time, though.
Boy, he's a patient man, though. He can really concentrate.
Yeah. Got to have it this time. Got it in good shape now. Sir, yep, he controlled it. The judges said he held it long enough, so it's a good lift.
Now Lars Hedlund, the Swedish lieutenant. I'd go up any beach he'd send me up. He scares you.
Yeah, he's definitely all Sweden, I'm sure. He holds the world record now in the bench press at about 614. So he has enormous strength in his chest and shoulders. Got it up, but no, he didn't quite control it. He didn't quite hold it long enough. Gee, it's so close.
He'll let out a bellow this time. He'll sound like he's wounded.
He'll be wounded. If he doesn't lift it, he'll be tied for second with Kazmaier, and Brown will win it.
A lot of breathing going on, getting ready.
No, that's it.
The winner of event number one, Don Reinhout, receives congratulations. Don Reinhout, the winner, with Hedlund and Kazmaier close by.
What do you like? Well, thank heavens, Cleve Dean's a good old boy.
How big is your forearm?
Well, like it is right now, about 18, but it'll probably go up to 19 or better.
If you're doing something with it, huh?
Yeah.
You're only 25 now, aren't you?
25 is right.
And, you know, this is the first time, Cleve, that you've been in this competition. You really didn't know what to expect. Are you surprised that these guys are that good, or that they're into this thing more than you are at this stage, you think?
Well, I'm surprised, and I'm not surprised, because some of these guys here, if you look at them, you can tell they look like they can handle anything in the world.
But you're going to go back to the farm. Now, you got a big pig farm down there. Now, your lady told me that one time a 600-pound sow was fooling around trying to get out, and that you reached over and grabbed her by the ears and pulled it up, spanked her, and stopped her and sent her back. Did you do that, really? Is that a true story?
I've caught hogs that weigh 600 pounds in a dead run.
And just stopped them?
Yeah.
That's pretty strong.
Didn't the sack stop them dead still. We tumbled a little while, but we stopped.
And these five competitors are going to tumble a lot over these bars of steel 11-16 inches thick. And four of the five larger competitors in this event.
Hey, John, look at the bend there. Cole really got it started then. Now, he's got it farther than anyone now. Although Cleve also has a good bend, but John's his father.
Kazmaier's
has got a good bend.
Lars, number two there on the right part of your screen, hasn't done much at all yet.
He's waiting.
All over 300 pounds, but John Cole right in the center of your screen.
Yeah, he's far smaller than the other four men.
Well, they're groaning and gnashing their teeth. It's wild.
Absolute effort. They're trying to get it past the point where they can use the great muscles of their shoulders on it.
Well, the people are really getting into this. They're really rooting.
He lost his towel, just bending it over his bare head now.
The leader right in the middle, it looks like John Cole.
Yeah, John's still in the lead.
Learned how to hold, blocking those linemen on Sunday afternoons. The winner looks to be John Cole and Cleve Dean pretty close.
I guess it only figures that somebody from Pittsburgh would be the guy that could build the steel bars, but congratulations,
thank
John.
You.
Quite enough.
Thank you very much. I'm just like Don Reinhold. I'm happy to be here.
About the fellow that you beat out by probably about an inch unofficially right now, but you're giving 200 pounds away to Big Dean over there, who is 465 pounds, but this is his first competition. Pretty good job by him, huh?
Sure was. Thank you. Thank you very much. The sucker here, as little as he hit, I'll just bob him on the head and get rid of him now.
The statistics tell the story. The measurement with Cole, of course, winning, also getting 10 points for first place. And after the first week of competition, Reinhout with a narrow lead over John Cole. Then it's Kazmaier, Hedlund, and Dean rounding out the top five.
No Scottish Highland Games. How about it, Doctor?
This really is a log, but in Scotland they call it a caber.
How long?
It's 14 feet long.
How much?
Weighs about 87 pounds. And the point is to pick it up in your hands, run with it, and make it turn over in the air. Okay. And these guys, I think, will throw it close to 40 feet.
The five finalists and their qualifying distances. Bill Anderson, 33 feet, 5 inches. John Kolb, 35, 1.5 inches. Big Bob Young, 36, 5.5 inches. Look out, Billy Kazmaier, 36, 9.5. And Lars Hedlund with the best toss in preliminaries, 37, 5.5 inches. Now to the finals for the best of two. Now, does Anderson really have an advantage in this last round, Terry?
Well, in a way, he may have a disadvantage because he practices to throw the thing straight rather than for distance. And that may work against him because he learned one technique and he has to kind of relearn another one here.
Pretty casual. Still got his watch on. Now you measure from the feet, right, to the end of the board?
That's right. From the end of the toe, the father's toe, to where the farthest end of the pole lands on the ground.
Not the bounce.
That's right. Not the bounce.
Very important. Let's see the finals now of the Kiever toss. 34-7. He improved on his preliminary's best toss. Bob Young, he's beefed up from football. I don't think he weighs that much when he plays offensive guard.
Well, close to that. He usually plays about 275, and he's now about 285.
285.
Yeah.
That's pretty casual, too. He's still got the shades on.
Yeah. Bob is going to handle this well, I think. He's very, very explosive. But he stepped forward. That's going to cost him a foot or so.
You're absolutely right. Let's see what the measurement is. It did cost Bob Young 34-9. That's not nearly as good as his best in the preliminaries. Lars Hedlund. By now, he's psyched up. He walks around, talks to people in the gallery, gets under the umbrella, comes back out.
Yeah, he did well last year in these events. He wants to do even better this year. It's a good throw. I think that may put him in first place. Let's see.
35, just over 35 feet. With Bill Kazmaier and John Cole left. There's Kazmaier. Breathing fire.
Yep, he needs to go over 35 feet to go into first place here.
Here's a dedicated guy, though. He works, what, 4 or 5 hours a day?
Yeah, he's training really hard. He's pulled his weight up about 50 pounds this last year.
He's backing down right now. He's got to get it going the right direction.
That's a fine throw. Even though he stepped forward, it cost him a foot, but I think that's well ahead of the best throw so far.
36, 6.5 inches. That's the leader by far. So John Kolb now, the Pittsburgh Steelers, back down between the rock and the hard place. I guess good athletes like that, though. He's just got to flat lay out the best throw, doesn't he?
Sure. He's the kind of guy that'll respond to pressure. He likes it this way. Such a fine athlete. He's learned this event well.
Good balance?
Yeah, very little practice, but you can see he already really has control of this thing.
Kolb's last toss.
Great height on it. Yes, sir. Does look good. Looks like a fine throw.
Let's wait for the official length on that one. If there were no scratches, that could be the winner. 36, 8.25 inches, and Kolb saved the best for last. And the numbers tell the story. John Kolb picks up 10 points and $500. Kazmaier second, Lars Hedlund third. And the new leader in the clubhouse after three events is John Kolb. 125 pounds or 925 deadlift. 2550 or 950 deadlift. Terry, what's he thinking?
Yeah, he knows that this is right near his limit. He has the lubrication, some sort of lubrication on his thighs so that the bar will slide up. He's really trying to concentrate and focus all of his energy and strength on this one great effort.
Remember, this big family man is 34 years of age and it's hot, boy. It's hot out here.
Starting to go. I think he's got. Yep. Yes, sir. He pulled it. He's sure.
What an effort. Uh-oh,
he's watching.
That is the maximum effort, isn't it? Yeah. Uses everything in the body.
Yeah, he's hyperventilated. He almost passed out.
Comes Kazmaier. Again, that spirits of ammonia, the inhaler there.
It's done in international competition, and all amateur sports allow the use of ammonia. Clear the head and focus the attention.
He looks through that car like he'd like to burn it up.
Now,
look at this.
He's going to bear down, turn into an animal to lift this weight. Got to have it. Uh-oh. Stand back. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you got it.
Kazmaier easily muscled that. And now Don Reinout, I believe, is thinking he may not lift again.
Just decided to let the young guy try to...
Well, I'm getting awful old for these things. I don't know.
He's 25.
Yeah, he's a little younger, a little more, you know, energy, I think, than I have. I gave it the best shot I thought I did, but...
Biggest lift you've ever had now?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, I think last year it came to around 8:10 that we did over here. And so, you know, quite a little bit of improvement.
Add 5 pounds. Billy Kazmaier now can be the outright winner. If he doesn't, if he fails, he'll be a tie with Reinout. He's going to attack it. It's good. Billy Kazmaier is the winner.
They tell me one of the most remarkable things about you is that you went from like a 275-pounder to like 330 in what, a year? And you didn't do it with just bulk, you did it with muscle, didn't you?
Well, I'm trying to pack it on, yeah. Trying to make it in the super heavyweight class of powerlifting. I've got to have the weight.
Did you learn a lot from the big fella, Don, the way he's...
He's a hero.
Huh?
He's a legend, yeah.
It's something to catch him,
it's
though,
fun
huh?
to compete with him.
Quite a guy that just won the car lift. Kazmaier getting 10 points. Reinhardt, second place, 7. Bob Young with 4. And after 2 weeks and 4 events, Billy Kazmaier is now the leader. John Kolb trails very closely, and we have 6 events and 3 weeks left.
These two guys should have good driving legs.
No question about it. This is two of the strongest offensive linemen in the game, maybe the two strongest. Bob is a little heavier. Yeah, he's got a good lead on Kolb.
He's going, what, 285?
Yeah, 285. Kolb about 260.
Two good times there. Let's check it out. Replay, you can see that the strong finish by Kolb didn't overtake Bob Young. We're going to grab Young right now.
All right, you are 14.3, somewhere in that, we haven't got the official time on it yet. You really did just get by him, but that was really a good race. You guys both performed pretty well, don't you think?
Very well. John's a very good athlete, great competitor.
Bob Young's time was 13.69, Kolb's 14.30. Remember, they are racing the clock while they're racing one another in these two-man heats. And look at this, Kazmaier gets Don Reinhardt. These are the bulls.
Yeah, these two big men should perhaps lower the best time so far. They're both tall, strong, heavy.
Boy, those wraps around the elbow look like they're
looking
down my leg.
Look at Kazmaier go. He did a 4.7 40 in college. Now, he's just running with the thing. Unbelievable. Oh, he almost went over the line, but still he's going to be way ahead.
And Reinhardt's done this before.
12.25, you were the leader coming in, so now you looks like you might pick up the 10 big ones on this, huh?
Yeah.
You know, you only won by like a quarter of a second. Don was right off your left tire.
Yeah, I started turning there.
Yeah?
It's tough coming in.
Have you practiced this before, or was this the first shot?
That's pretty much my first time with something that heavy.
Pretty much the first time. Pretty good time. 12.25, the leader. And, of course, the big fella, Reinhardt's at 12.99. We'll get our final competitor in this. This is Joe Doobie from Florida. And Jerry Blackwell, by the way, the professional wrestler, is out of the competition due to that injury, Terry. So Doobie's going to go alone. It'll be a little tougher by
this. This will definitely make it harder for Joe. He's a great, powerful athlete himself. He's not trained quite as hard lately as these other men, but still he's doing very well. He's moving the thing. 100 feet up the hill at 750 pounds. It's a heck of a race.
Is it legs more than anything?
Legs, hips, lower back, arms, everything.
Doobie at 16.48, not really in the chase. You can see the wheelbarrow results. Billy Kazmaier, Reinhardt Young, Hedlund, and John Kolb. The standings? We're only halfway through week number 3.
Playboy Clever upstairs. A lot of work going to go on down under here. So we'll go to my expert analyst, my doctor of power. And Terry, it's a fancy-looking lift, but it's a tough lift, isn't it?
Yeah, it's almost enough to make me want to come out of retirement, I'll tell you.
This one could do it, right?
Yes, if anything could, that would do it.
Okay, what about Kazmaier, of course, leads. We've already seen him go for a world record last week, lifting the automobile. Is he just going to stomp right through this thing?
No, I don't think so. I think Reinhardt would have to be the favorite in this. He won it last year with 790 pounds, but I do think he's going to need more than that to win this year, but I think he can do more this year.
Maximum effort. Do you think that you bunnies from the Los Angeles Playboy Club are going to be able to get a maximum effort down here from these guys? What about it, folks? All right? All right. Let's lift away on the girl lift, okay? Let's get with it.
You're looking at the knees of Bob Young being wrapped. It's Don Reinhardt and Bob Young still in. They're going to lift half a ton in the girl lift. That's a lot.
I guess it is. They're going to try it. This is well over the world record in the squat in powerlifting. This is a slightly different event, but still, 1,000 pounds, no matter how you cut it, it's just a remarkable, amazing amount of weight to try to lift with the
now,
hips
sort
and
of a,
legs.
Young sort of attacks it, doesn't he? He walks in like he's bullish.
Yeah, but this is so much weight. No, he started it, but it's just too much. I think he realizes he's going to have to stand back and see if the big man from New York can do it.
Let's sit with Bob Young and watch Don Reinhardt try for the 1,000 pounds.
Bob, you and your brother, I think, decided to use a little strategy and go for the 1,000 and almost an impossible lift, but now at least you can split maybe first place points, huh?
Well, Don possibly could miss it. He'll probably make it, but he could miss it.
Now, here the big fellas going. We'll sort of watch it together.
You folks remember now that Reinhardt is really trying something monumental, 1,000 pounds. Listen to the chatter now. What is he concentrating? 1,000 pounds. Beautiful girls above him. He doesn't know any of that right now. He's just thinking position,
an execution. A lot more cerebral than you think, isn't it, folks? He's ready now.
All right, he got it. You all right?
I don't want you to black out, my friend. I'm sitting over there with Bob Young, who said he thought you would make it. That's an incredible feat.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate that. Huh? Thank you.
How about that beautiful load you had? Oh, 1,000 pounds and all, though, huh?
Can I keep them now that I lifted them?
Is it the best lift you've ever had, do you think?
Yes, sir. That's the best I've ever done. I'm really honored. That's just honored to be here. And
you're never going to get old. You know what? You're getting younger every day.
Oh, gosh. Thank you. We keep trying anyway.
How about this, the champion? Huh? That was a tough one, 1,000.
Thank you.
Don Reinout coming on strong in the girl lift. You can see he picked up 10 points. Young and Kazmaier close behind. And now Reinout's moved Bass Kolb into second place, and Kazmaier still leads.
Dean Hoyston, this looks like a tough event, Terry.
Yeah, this is a hard event. It's an event where body weight is not as big as an advantage as it is in the other events.
The hand strength again, is this upper body?
Yeah, mostly upper body. Hand strength, forearm strength, back strength.
And calluses on the hands. It looks like it's going to be tough on that rope.
Yeah. Dave Johns is a bodybuilder. He weighs about 235 pounds, and I think he ought to be given a medal for bravery to just be here against these Johns, because he's facing Cleve Dean, a pig farmer from South Georgia who weighs 460.
Cleve gets in, I think it looks like his school desk back in that little schoolroom in Georgia.
No problem.
Ooh. Cleve gets it to the top, and so does Johns.
Very good job for both men.
Two competitors are now out due to injuries. That's, of course, Anderson the Big Scott and Blackwell, a professional wrestler.
Here's Joe Doobie on the left from Florida. He was World Olympic lifting champion in 1969. He's going against John Cole, the Pittsburgh Steeler offensive lineman. See, they're held down by the brace on the top of their thighs, and they have to pull this weight, which is now 290 pounds, all the way up until it hits the top and hopefully locks in. Sometimes the apparatus doesn't work and the helpers grab it so that the men don't get hurt.
Oh, yeah. 30 seconds, too. There is a clock factor.
They're really not going against one another. They're going against the clock, and they're going against the weight of the apparatus. We'll increase it as we get higher.
That's Billy Kazmaier on the left at 315 pounds?
Yeah, 315 pounds. He's a strength coach at Auburn University. Lars Hedlund is a powerlifting champion of Europe and a lieutenant in the Swedish Army.
Okay,
also
Lieutenant.
About 310. Both men should be able to pull this one. Yep. Lars. Uh-oh, apparatus problem.
The touch was made.
Yeah, he got it. So did Bill.
Nobody eliminated yet. This is the hoist. That's Bob Young, the 280-pound offensive lineman, and Don Reinhout to the right.
Yeah, Don Reinhout, the powerlifting champion. Now, Bob has gloves on, but apparently he can't hold it. The gloves just don't have as good a gripping surface as your hands would.
Well, now, he's had some hand trouble anyway due to injury now.
Broken many times, his hands. He's always had a problem with his hands. And that's he's going to be given another chance.
That's Dave Kagi, and of course, Jack Curran is the Lakers trainer, the trainer for our World's Strongest Men.
See how much better he's doing it now. He's able to... He's having pain, though, but... No.
Not quite up. Now the weight goes up to 350. You've got to use the back on this, too.
Oh, yeah, you can see the men laying back on it. You have to have the hands to hold it, and then you have to actually pull it. It's too much to pull just with your arms. You have to use your whole body, at least as much of your body as the apparatus allows you to use.
Doobie on the left and John Kolb on the right. Kolb is a darn good competitor.
Oh, Kolb's got some of the strongest hands in the world. He's just amazing. You can see Joe is having problems with Big John. Got it to the top. Yep.
Touched up. Amazing athlete for small at 260 around here.
Yeah, against these giants. There's two men over 300 pounds, very well built. Neither one even have a 40-inch waist.
Wish I could say that. Okay, Kazmaier on the left. And big Lars Hedlund.
You can see Bill's hands are so thick, there's not much room for the rope once he closes them. He wants more stick, I heard him say.
Muscles in his fingers too, huh?
Yeah. See the hands? See how thick they are?
Size of that.
He doesn't have as much gripping surface as the other men do. No, you can see it sliding through
his
hands.
The clock is still moving. Oh, there it is.
Didn't do it.
Kazmaier is out.
It's going to be a problem for him in points.
Reinhardt never seems to be out.
No.
Couldn't get it?
No, he almost got it, but he couldn't quite. He missed it. Cleve passed on 350 pounds. Didn't even try it. He said, no, he wanted to wait. Give him 370. He had done something like 400 back down on the pig farm this way, but it's on a different apparatus. No, he's having trouble. It's not hand trouble for him. It's
the wrist wrestling champion of the world. That's true.
Gee, look at that. Not quite. He's not going to be able to do it. It was a bad gamble on his part.
That's the reason the varied events really do give you a severe test of
no
who
question.
Is the strongest man overall.
They test pretty well every muscle in the entire body.
Here's Colbert. Here's a guy that really knows how to compete. He finds out the best way he could do it and seems to operate there.
John has a perfectly built hands for this event because his hands are very long, broad, and flat. They're not fleshy at all, and so he has a lot of grip surface to put onto that rope.
The perfect hands. Here we
go. Perfect hands for an offensive lineman. Look at him now.
This guy in the line of scrimmage can tear your shirt off.
Yeah, the man is he's double tough. I think he's got a shot at this one.
He's been a dark horse competitor already.
Yes,
now he's doing well
in
this.
This
takes
is a,
in line.
Just a couple more pulls.
You
he got it.
It.
Yes, sir. Terrific.
But this big Swede's going to try the 370-pounder, too, Terry. He's got a lot of pizzazz, though, doesn't he? He's always shouting and getting himself...
He's a really rugged guy. The more I see him, the more I respect him. His hands are not as large as John's are, but he's a little stronger in his shoulders, I think, than John. And I just don't know whether he's going to be able to hold onto that rope long enough so that those strong shoulders can pull it all the way to the top.
Swedish Army must be something else. No wonder they never have a problem.
I don't think they need anybody but Lars. Send them all home.
About an inch and a half rope?
Yeah, just about.
Got it, Lars. Got it. Hands on him.
See, he's keeping his arms bent, whereas John kept them straight. He's using the upper body strength more than he's using the back. But I believe he... Yes, sir. He
got it.
Terrific. Terrific effort.
What an effort. Both of them look like they're spent. I think they may just go ahead and split first place and go to the next event. And so the hoist lift goes to two big blind gentlemen. Kolb and Hedlund split the first place points. And the standings now, that means Hedlund has moved past Bob Young into fourth place, Kazmaier, Reinhardt, and John Kolb in third. The tram pull. And a definite style, I would imagine, is needed to get the darn thing started.
Yeah, the men need to stay low. Now, Don has a big advantage because he's about 70 pounds heavier than Bob. And as you can see, that weight is a big advantage. Also, the size of the feet makes a difference. Cleve Dean should be great at this and a little off. But see, Don wears a 15.
Ooh,
look
right
at
now,
it. He's got
Walker.
A big lead.
Left on your left
now,
there.
Bob tried to get up too quick. Oh, yeah, look at that. Just walking with it, isn't he? Really powerful. Over 10,000 pounds.
And a bunch of screaming kids that are really pulling for Don Reinhardt. That's Bob Young.
You stayed down until about halfway, and you finally got that turn moving, and then you came up sort of and began to run with it.
Yes, sir. That's hard.
God, was this as good a run as you had last year? You won this event, didn't you?
Yes, it was a little bit shorter, but it's pretty close to the same time, I think, and it was 2,000 pounds more.
You just never quit, do you, big fella?
I have to stay in it. I came a long ways to compete.
Reinhardt's time, 24.39. Young, 30.42. They're actually racing the clock and their own tramway, right?
That's right. It's a head-to-head competition, but they're still actually competing against the clock. Now, Cleve got up a little too quick that
Cleve
time.
Cleve Dean is far away from the camera. This is Dave Johns, the Mr. Universe here.
He's twice as heavy as the man he's going against. You can see the terrific trouble that a 230-pound strong man like Dave Johns is having with this thing. That gives you an idea of how much weight this really is.
Well, you're right. Dave Johns is really struggling.
Now look at the feet on Cleve. You see those big 17s or 18s? He's headed into the barn. Looks like he's going home for supper.
Five platters of fried chicken coming up.
the cooties around that Georgia pig farm of yours, baby. You came out of the blocks. 29, 29 seconds. Good run.
Well, yeah.
You had to
we're getting out of the window.
You had to, well, we don't know yet. You know, you might put some heat on somebody. That might get you some points and get you out of, what are you, in sixth place right now?
Yeah.
You got a chance to jump. I like your chances.
I hope so.
And you're still young and handsome, too.
And a great sense of humor. Okay, heat number three, Billy Kazmaier against Joe Doobie. Now, Kazmaier's a young guy. He might have a little problem.
Yeah, he's above a looking sea. He's starting up too high. No, he's making a big mistake. I don't care how big and how strong you are. If you don't stay low in this event at the first, you're out of luck. See, Doobie's got a lead. Yeah. See, and he keeps trying to stand up. And it's much too early. He doesn't have the speed up enough on the tram. See, Doobie's got a lead on him. Now Kazmaier's greater strength is beginning to show up a little bit. Doobie's having some trouble.
Got up too high, it looks like. Far lane is Joe Doobie from Florida. Billy Kazmaier, now they're just about a dead heat right now.
Yeah, but they're both, the tram's moving too slow. They can't really bend into the weight properly and make it really go.
Right now, time was 24.39.
Not a good time.
Okay. Oxygen. One of the most demanding events in the entire competition so far has been this tram pull. They do need that oxygen as soon as they hit the finish line.
Oh, yeah. Tremendous oxygen debt in this thing.
Here's John Cole now. Not too heavy in the near court, so to speak, and big Lars Hedlund, a ton over in the other one.
Oh, yeah, that body weight advantage is really showing in this event. Even though John's staying low and he's doing well, but still he's only 260 against an over 10,000-pound vehicle. Yeah, and see, he's leaning into it, got a great angle on his body. He's really making it move now. Going to have a good time, I think.
You realize
everybody does better. It seems to be doing better in that lane.
I was just starting to say we haven't had a winner among some of the athletes in the yellow lane yet. Here are the results of that first heat in the tram pool. There's going to be a runoff heat when we come back here on the World's Strongest Men competition. Here are those heats for the second tram pool. It's found that the blue course to the left was a little bit swifter, so everybody switches lanes and now goes for a combined two heat total to see who's going to win this. Here we go. That's right out to the right. And Bob Young of the Cardinals, now at the top of your screen.
Well, Bob didn't think that Don should beat him as badly as he did the first time. And it looks like he is at least dead even with the big guy now.
Reinhardt's up and walking, though.
Yeah, he's about 70 or 80 pounds heavier than Bob, but Bob's got a little lead on him.
Those kids are screaming like mad look for each other. Look at this.
Over 10,000 pounds, and Bob's almost running with it. Now, Don's making a surge here, but nope, Bob nipped him.
Bob Young wins it. The combined total now, Reinhardt, 49.94, Young at 55.58. Cleve Dean, near camera. He almost takes up the whole lens at 465. That's Billy Kazmaier to the left.
Kazmaier gives away a lot of weight, but he's a very powerful man. And in the faster lane, perhaps he might be able to make up. He was 36 seconds and changed the first time. Looks like he's doing a lot better. He's leaning more into the weight now. Looks like he learned a little bit how to run the event. But Cleve, yes, sir. Cleve's not giving it up.
And he's got those mammoth feet on that.
Yes, look at
pavement.
That. Very close. It's going to be almost. Boy, that's photo finish.
Dean is given the nod by 0.02 of a second. Now the combined totals as we're into our second heat show. You right now still the leader. Kazmaier now in fourth. Young followed by Big Cleve Dean. Okay, Lars did it well in this, got up very early, but he's against John Kolb, who can compete just about any way you want to.
Yes, he can. And they've switched lanes now, and Kolb is in what's supposed to be the faster lane. You see how heavy that thing is, Tom? It's hard for them to even get it started. But look at John. Look how he's staying down.
Well, Lars is big, too, though. He is coming out.
He's coming on, but John's got a big lead now.
Looks like
he's drive blocking, doesn't he?
He's got the arms moving, getting all he has into him.
No wonder Harvey Martin has trouble with him. Look at that.
Lars comes on strong at the finish. Let's see these combined totals. There's some struggling going on. The reason is money and, of course, pride. Consistency by Don Reinhout. His two-run total, 49.94. Lars Hedlund moving up, and Bob Young in third place. But it's Reinhout picking up 10 points. The old veteran moves past Billy Kazmaier into first place in the overall standings. Lars Hedlund making a move. John Kolb still very much alive. Go to the Next to the last event here at the World's Strongest Men. Number 9, the refrigerator race. What about it, Terry?
Well, it's an uphill race, slightly uphill. The refrigerator, as we said before, weighs a little over 400 pounds. It's strapped onto the body, and as you can see, it has supports on it, which allow the athlete to fall, if that should happen, without danger.
Okay, John Kolb on the right. Billy Kazmaier on the left.
Ooh. Oh, no.
Kolb is down. Now, let's see what it is.
Can't tell. Oh, a strap. Looks like a strap broke, yeah.
Okay, Kazmaier, of course, didn't even look into his rearview mirror. He just steamed on home here. Pretty good shape. That is a tremendously heavy thing to have on there, huh?
Oh, well, he's going to try to come on limp on in. Even he's just holding it there. The strap's not helping him. He's just holding it there with main strength.
John Kolb.
Quite an effort.
34.26, his belated time. Kazmaier at 18.13. I'm getting some help right now. Now, Kolb might have an option on this and probably get a free run by himself. We'll have to wait and see what happens on that.
Yeah, he'll have to look at the points and decide whether he wants to make the effort to do it again.
See, the time was not good, but this is a tough, grueling part of it. This might be one of the toughest events I've seen.
Because of the equipment failure, Bob is running by himself here. Okay. Of course, that's a little bit of a disadvantage to him, but since they're just running against the clock, it doesn't really matter.
Hey, he's tripping it off. He's moving some.
Yeah, going pretty good. He realizes he can't get into the finals. He can't get into the top four, so he's not giving it quite the effort that perhaps he could.
I think for a guy that has no chance of getting to the finals, he's giving it a lot of effort.
Moving it pretty good, though.
It's like the line coaches yelling at him at St. Louis. Bob Young with a 19.47.
In second place.
Cleve Dean, he's the only one, I guess, that's probably bigger than the
Yes, Cleve is actually
isobox, huh?
Larger than the isobox.
People really began to pick up on this young guy. Hear the yelling good on
his head? Yeah, he's a big favorite. Look at him. That's about Cleve's normal pace there. I don't think he notices that refrigerator.
I think he'd like to open it and get into it and find out what's in there.
No doubt he's done that a few times. Fine time.
$17.45,
Cleve. I enjoy it. Like it, love it.
You know, somebody said that when you were practicing with this the other day that you went back to the hotel, forgot you had it on your back, trying to get the elevator.
I don't think it's quite that bad.
But you did say this is on the only thing, really one of the events where you weighed more than the event did, so you thought you might be able to handle this, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Good job, though, huh?
Thank you.
You were coming
Appreciate
home.
It. Trying to.
There are the times. The leader is Big Cleve Dean, 17.45. Hey, now the apparatus is fixed again.
Yeah, the apparatus is fixed, and so both men are going to go. Lars Hedlund and Don Reinhout.
Now, is Reinhout going to give it an all-out one? He's got a lead coming in.
Yeah, I think he wants to protect his lead, and so I think you can expect a good effort from him. But Lars, who won this event last year, is really good at it. He really seems to know just how to do those little short steps.
Look at that. He just trips along.
Yeah.
For a guy 300-something, he has vaulted it.
He can, you know, he'd be dangerous in the NFL, wouldn't he?
Wow, look at the time. Lars Hedlund, 13.73, wins it. Don Reinhout, second, 15.44.
John Kolb was given a chance by the officials to run the event again because the equipment failed on him, but he decided to forego that chance and save himself for the final competition in the tug-of-war.
Did you yell at the refrigerator? Somebody said you took a bite out of it before you got ready and got in there.
Yeah, I get mad.
You ready to go?
I'm sure.
Last event?
No, it's the final. Let's take it.
Okay, we've got one more event. Let's check the steadies right now and see where we are. We're going to have one strongest man. Getting close because of Lars Hedlund's big win in that refrigerator race, getting 10 points. And the top four are preparing now for that tug of war. Bob Young in fifth place gets a $1,000 bonus.
Yeah, it's an old event, steeped in tradition. And they came here to decide who the best man was. And I think if any event can separate, this is the event.
Somebody said that Don Reinhout might just lay back, get a little advantage, and then put it in park and sit it out.
Yeah. They tell me he's been training against two football players that weigh 560 pounds together, and that he's a match for them, so he's going to be hard to beat in this event.
And here are the pairings in this tug-of-war, the final event at the World's Strongest Men Competition. Billy Kazmaier will go against John Kolb, then Don Reinhout will go against Lars Hedlund, and then the winners will tangle later on. Now, Kolb cannot win the overall championship.
That's right. Even if he wins this event, he can't win the overall competition because he doesn't have enough points. But he can affect the standings. If he beats Kazmaier in this tug, he will eliminate Kazmaier's chances to win the overall competition.
He could really be the spoiler then and virtually decide who's going to win it?
He sure could.
I like it. You know how he likes that underdog role.
Okay.
What about the sand? How deep is it? What's the strategy going to be here, Terry?
It's several feet deep. These men have to draw the other man, some part of the other man's body, across that line. And if at the end of 1 minute time limit, that one man has not reached the line, then whoever has the most rope over the center is the winner.
What early advantage looks like John Cole.
That's amazing. He's able to help. I thought Kazmaier would walk right out with him, but he's not. Kazmaier is standing up, and that's a big mistake.
How much digging down can you do? It looks like cold.
He's lying back, you see, but you can't lie back on the sand for more than 5 seconds at a time.
Okay. He stayed as far back in the midline, though, as possible.
Yeah, you get much, much better leverage by lying back as far as you can. Kazmaier's he's standing up. You see that? That's a big mistake.
Now, Cole has given away, what, 60 pounds?
Yeah, 60, 65 pounds.
Look at that. It's in the center court.
Still a fight, though. But time and, I think, endurance is on Cole's side because he's a smaller man and in better condition. And I think what looks like Bill is running out of gas.
Tell you, we've all tugged on a rope, though. That could take it all out of you.
Look at that. Not quite over yet, but he's gone now. That's it.
John Cole is the upset winner again.
What a disappointment to Bill.
Now, John Cole, who really has been sensational. He has never counted himself out or been out, and he may rest and have to come back and tug of war again.
Last shot, Don. Why not? This is your chance. You win this this particular tug of war, you are the world's strongest man. Good luck to you, all right?
Thank you, sir. Appreciate that.
And Lars, a big man from Sweden, you have really been able to decide this thing by coming on this last day for a tremendous finish. Good luck to you. Man your ropes and let's go at it, huh?
Okay. Some kind of a psych job by the big Swede. He looked Reinhardt not in the eye, just like he almost with disdain. He wanted to get at it.
Listen, Tom, he's ready. He wants this. He knows that if he can beat Don, he's got a chance to win the overall competition. He can come back and beat Kolb in the finals.
Oh boy, Reinhardt.
First, he's got to beat a 350-pound tiger.
Reinhardt just pulled him almost out of the sand.
Yeah. But look at him. He's reeling Don in now. But he's almost over the line. He's right up to the...
Dangerous strategy by Lars.
He's got a lot of rope, you see. He's almost over the line himself.
He's working on Reinhardt's into the rope. Man.
Very risky business. One jerk and Don could pull him over.
Very close to
you
being
see
over.
That? He's got to get back up within 5 seconds.
Hedlund's got an advantage now. He's got the big fella down.
Yes.
Hedlund's working right at the rim.
And the time is almost up now. There's very little time left.
Very little rope between them. Mm. Reinhardt is really in trouble.
They're both playing out.
5 seconds left.
His hand's over the line now.
He's done.
Yep, he's done.
Lars Hedlund in a great bit of strategy.
Oh, look at the guy go down. 60 seconds of terminal all-out effort.
John Kolb isn't through yet, but he does get fourth place, and his total money will be $4,571.50. Billy Kazmaier gets third place and over $7,500. And here's the big fellow who could win it all with his final great week of competition, Lars Hedlund.
He's made a great surge, and if he can beat Kolb...
I wouldn't bet against Kolb for
anything. He's the champion.
I think the craziest thing about the tug-of-war competition is the strategy. I can't believe that there are several different ways you can do it and be a winner.
Yeah, Lars seems to favor standing straight up, whereas John falls back and uses more leverage and more athletic ability.
Now, Lars also tries to work up and get too close to the middle line. Is that a dangerous thing to do?
I think it is a dangerous thing to do. He was able to pull it off last time, but that last one must have taken a lot out of him.
He's got a weight advantage over John Kolb, right?
Weight advantage, but probably a cardiovascular disadvantage. They're just holding right now, trying to wait to let the other one make the first move and counterattack.
Kolb has got the yellow ribbon on his side.
Yes, he has. You see the difference? Lars is standing up where he uses just the muscles of his upper body, and John is going to the lower body. His legs are stronger than arms.
Lars looks like he's sort of tethering him out, like, I can take you any time I want to. Lars's feet are pretty close together now.
Very close. It looks to me as if... Yep, John's strategy looks like it's paying off now.
We see his fast hands.
He's
look
almost
at this.
Going over.
It's over.
He's over.
It's
it. That's it. Reinhardt wins.
And Lars can't believe it. This makes Don Reinhardt the winner.
Yes, sir. He's the champion.
Time after time, we've seen John Kolb, apparently out of the contest, beat men that are much larger and much more experienced. He's quite a competitor.
Yeah, he won for himself, and he won for Don Reinhardt. It's just an amazing feat of athletic ability.
And the big Swede, Lars Hedlund, gets second place, $9,780, to the champion, whose middle name might be competitor, Don Reinhardt.